Okay, babe. Look, I'm just gonna take the high road here. Right? I'm sorry that things have escalated so fast. I'm just gonna calmly ask you a couple of questions, okay? I would really love it if you could just tell me the truth.
Babe, I always tell you the truth, to the best of my ability. Dr. Tucker said that a relationship is, two people that are doing their best.
Right. Yeah, I'm doing my best for you right now, and I'm just hoping that you can try to do your best for me too, okay?
I mean, Charlie, come on, man. I mean, whatever the fuck is going on, or whatever the fuck you think is going on, let's just talk about it, all right? Like, let's work it out.
Yeah. Where were you last night?
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, Charlie, last night was Wednesday night. I work every fucking Wednesday night. I'm not gonna go through this shit with you every Thursday morning, I know what's up. You got your fucking period, don't you? Come on, don't get pissed, I'm right. You get pissed off every time you get your period. I'm just fucking saying, it's true. Call me Dick Wolf.
Babe, stop. Why don't you just let me do a little bit of talking now, okay? Just sit back, relax. Not one more word out of you, okay? No, not one more fucking word out of your mouth. Daddy Bear, you know how Mama Bear here pays your cell phone bill, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, unfortunately, for your sake, when somebody pays somebody else's cell phone bill, they get full and complete records of all text messages and incoming and outgoing calls, right? Oh, there it is. So, I know everything. I mean, I kind of feel bad for you right now.
Okay, hey, all right, Charlie, come on, calm down. Look, you know what, you're right, I'm sorry. I fucked up. Whatever I need to say right now to fix this or make this okay for you, I'm gonna say it. Charlie, there's good stuff.
Baby.
Here.
So here's where I'm at. You are a liar and a cheat. That's a no-brainer though, isn't it? So I guess I'm just kind of wondering, what do you think should happen right now? Because I know exactly what I would do. So I guess I'm just curious. Do you have any final thoughts?
Someone asked me once what I thought it meant to be a woman today in 2018. I replied, "Oh my God, I have no fucking idea." I mean, shit, I really don't know. I can't sum that up in a sentence. It's so layered and textured. What I do know is this won't be one of those coming-of-age tales where the girl gets her period, empowers herself, and eventually becomes a woman. However, God is a woman. Women give life. Look at the woman's body. Our hair, curves, the mind of a woman, our scent. For centuries, we have been taught by men how to behave out of fear, been told when to talk and what to say. If we didn't follow these instructions, we were cunts and didn't deserve love. We remain strong yet gentle, nurturing, caring, soft. Yet we can bear this threshold of pain that most men would totally snap. I mean, we bleed and heal once a month, for crying out loud. We adapt, mold ourselves to be whatever we need to be. All loving for the most part. Us good ones at least. I guess what I'm saying is, God has to be a woman.
God, please watch over me and my family. Watch over the girls and the women. Keep us safe out here in these streets. Please cover my haters in your precious blood. Forgive them, for they know not what they do.
Yo. Hey, girl.
I thought Nina was already here. Can you stop her?
Shelly, do you believe in God?
Like that big old guy lives in the sky, the one you gotta fear if you fuck up?
Yeah. Him, I guess. Also, I haven't talked to Nina. She hasn't replied to my text.
I have a hard time believing that you're supposed to live in fear. I mean, does that even make sense to you?
God is a woman.
Okay, but what?
Damn, stupid whore bitch. Watch where you're going.
Okay, bro, you ran into me. And also, does your mother know that you're out here disrespecting women and acting like an asshole without any manners?
I don't have a mom, so like, no.
It's okay. What's your name?
No, I'm sorry. Have a good day. I'm obviously having a really bad one.
I'm Josh.
Be good. Hang in there, Angel. Just don't go around calling women whore bitches. It's not cute.
God is a woman.
Damn. Word. What is a woman's worth? What defines me? Ugh, fuck, seriously? Just because my Tinder handle is vegan looking for me doesn't mean I want to fuck. If I choose to embrace my sensuality and sexuality, it shouldn't mean I'm a $5 hot and ready Little Caesars pizza. Whatever, it's all narcissism and validation. My first boyfriend, well, actually, my first boyfriend was Ralphie from age 4 to 11. Mary and I shared him, and he was perfect. No one will ever be as good as Ralphie. Anyway, when I was 13, this kid named Brad asked me to be his girlfriend. And ew, he totally grossed me out. But I didn't want to hurt his feelings, so I said yes. Who does that? I could tell all of his friends were making fun of him, and I thought, you have to kiss him. I was so repulsed by him. I remember going with him to this party, and we wound up in a room alone, and he used my hand to touch himself, and I froze. The next day, he told everyone that we did anal and BJs. I was 13. The truth is, I just felt sorry for him. I didn't even know what that stuff was at the time. His mother and I have the same name, and I wonder if it was weird for him moaning my name for those 160 seconds and then lying to everyone telling them he did anal and BJs with Nina. You really can't write this stuff.
Nina, what happened? We called you like 50 times.
Have you just been here this whole time? Wait a second. How was your Tinder date?
Okay, 21 questions. Hello to you guys too. My phone was on silent. I've just been sitting here thinking.
About what?
Ralphie.
Oh, Ralphie. Swoon.
Oh, and my date? It was whatever. I couldn't tell if he was attractive or just tall and white. Honestly, I was just bored and horny. I'll probably ghost him. He was chill though.
God is a woman.
Yo, but not even like that Ariana Grinder song. More of a Joan Osborne, One of Us tip. She's been going on about this all morning, but I think she's onto something.
Yeah, I know. She texted me that this morning. In the name of the Mother, Daughter, and Holy Spirit, amen. You guys want to catch the sunset on the roof?
Amen.
I'm so down.
Wait, I have a great idea. Vegan looking for meat? Come with me.
They say chivalry is dead. Well, great. I hope they buried it deep. I can open my own doors, thank you very much. I was on my way into work the other day, and I saw this little girl that could not have been older than 6 or 7, completely untouched and unscathed of gender roles. She was with her mother and brother, who was about 8. She ran ahead of her mother and opened the door for her. She held it for her and for her brother, and then quickly caught up after everyone else made their way inside. I thought, this girl is a fucking hero. I want my daughter to be just like her. And then I thought how long it would take before she learned she has to wait for men to open the door for her. And at what point she realized she wasn't equal. And that some men would fear her. That it would be best if she just smiled and nod. Or maybe not. Maybe she'll never buy into what crap they're preaching. Whatever.
This is so beautiful. It's exactly what I needed.
God is.
We'll be right back.
heat advisory has been issued for the entire world. We have reached a heat index that has been registered as literal hell.
It's hell on Earth, but hell is Earth, and Earth is about to get a whole lot hotter.
I'm a girl boss, I'm killing it, and I'm not worrying about the haters. Get ready, because I'm about to take over the world.
I'm a total badass. My parents died when I was 8. I had to plan their funeral. Now, I plan events for celebrities.
Stop interning and get a real job? Only when hell freezes over. I've never built anything except for my brand.
Together, they're gonna build the perfect brand. Things are about to get a whole lot hotter. It's literally hell.
That's Hot Tanning Salon. I just have like really big plans for the future. I'm really excited. I run my own business.
Here is a list of our hurricane names. And it looks as though this next one is Hurricane Dick. Look at all the pollution. Yeah. Temperature for October is unseasonably warm.
Hi, Angel.
How are you?
I'm good.
You look so hot.
Thank you. It's like chilly out today though. It's like 104, I think.
Oh my God, I am like freezing.
It's cold.
Ooh, so cold. I'm really looking forward to like, you know, climate change. So you're gonna tan?
Yeah, I think like maybe the huge, but I think I want to do like a little bit hotter.
Mm-hmm. Okay, your goggles.
Perfect. So I actually wanted to talk to you, Angel, because I was watching the news.
Babe, I told you not to watch that.
I know. They were saying, well, they were trying to say.
What were they trying to say?
Tanning gives you cancer.
I'm not worrying about the haters. Don't listen to the haters. The people on the news are haters.
I know.
Don't listen to the haters. And never worry about how you feel. It's about how you look. Yeah, so I've hired Caitlin, who's like a really amazing PR expert.
Then I wound up in PR.
Caitlin's gonna throw me an amazing party.
I just love working for Satan. She is just such a sweetheart. The whole vibe of like poolside, tanning, hot, tan, poolside vibe, right? Okay, and that is how I came up with a theme for your party. The theme is water.
I'm really excited.
We're gonna be bringing awareness to the whole water situation. There is like no water.
I was just like envisioning just like a global campaign. Food shortages, perpetual wars.
There's no water, so we're actually not giving the water away.
Yeah, I'm just like really excited to be here for like the end of times. Like none of my friends get to be here. And like the fact that Caitlin brought me on board in spite of like other people who are like vying for this position are probably like way more qualified.
Did you use the flash?
I think so.
Are you using-
Just like means the world.
I think social media is amazing.
We're gonna bring attention to it. We're gonna make it hot. We are building your brand. That's enough.
Okay, yeah.
That's enough. Mm-hmm. Nope, and that's enough.
And this is a paid internship.
So hashtags. Okay, how about this? Water for women. Feminism is fluid.
You think about it.
I love that. Okay, she loves it. She loves it. Great, we're done. That's good.
I love it.
Yeah, I think it's perfect.
It's perfect.
We made that happen.
On the next, literally hell.
No one's at the event.
When are the people gonna show up?
Are you pregnant?
It's about Hollywood.
Hey.
I think the glaciers should like melt away.
Tune in Sundays at 6 a.m.
I'm glad we caught that matinee. I can't believe Jim Carrey died during filming and they still put that out. He was a great Terrence McKenna. I can see why Hollywood would want to pay tribute to him, especially after they dumped all that cash into it. But they really fucked up on the CGI. Like, I was not convinced that that was a machine elf or that it was the DMT world or whatever. It was not good.
Dude, do you think people actually come from stoned apes?
I don't know. I'm feeling like a stoned ape. And the clock just struck 4:20.
Yo, I can't give you a ride home, dude. If I'm late again, they're gonna fire me.
It's fine, man. I'm gonna take the Stabway.
The Stabway at night?
Yeah. I mean, it's not like people actually get stabbed on there. It's just a short cut across town.
It's not a stab across town.
Whatever, man.
I'm good. Lucas, why the fuck did you say that to him?
I couldn't help it, man. At the time, I really couldn't help it.
I think she liked it.
Really?
Weed treats for sale. You want to get high, my guy?
What do you got?
I call it the It's Thing. The original ice cream sandwich. One bite will get you lit. Or eat the whole thing and go to the moon.
Okay, sounds pretty good.
That'll be 4:20.
We only got a 5.
Well, that's gonna be an 86 donut tax.
That's fine, that's fine. It's pretty good. Huh? Where'd he go?
Coneheads. Does it remind you of the Coneheads?
I mean, the Dan Aykroyd movie? It kind of looked like Zordon to me.
Yeah, Zordon could have been a Conehead. Dan Aykroyd's connected with the aliens. He's gonna usher in a new era of peace and prosperity in the galaxy.
Uh-huh. Can we go around the roundabout again?
I mean, yeah, we can.
nice, man.
You should hit this. I could eat like 3 hamburgers right now.
What do you think of that guy?
Is he staring at us?
I think so.
Here.
That dochi to the left hand side.
Here you go.
It's still there.
Yeah, still standing right there.
Still standing right there.
Hey!
Whatever.
Well, at least it's not a tweaker.
He's a creeper.
Right. the cause of all this?
I think you're evil!
Hey, dude.
Man, it's you.
Garden Shears, $23.99. Aisle 1, Bay 13.
Huh? Are you for real? Fucking shit! The hell is that? Hydroponic? The hell?
I need some help regarding an issue that I can't go to the police with. I feel there's an urgency to this thing. I was doing some catfishing, and it appears that I'm being catfished now. I was making videos of myself doing things, and then I found a box on my doorstep, and it was a video of me making the video, and then I was panicking, and so I was hungry, and like, I made a sandwich, and then my doorbell rang, and I opened the door, and there was nobody there, and there was a box, and there was a VHS tape, and I put the VHS tape in the TV, and it was a film of, like a video of a person making sandwiches, but it was me on the video, and it was me making sandwiches. It was a video of me making sandwiches on a video of me making sandwiches, and and I'm not sure if the meat was like me. And then my phone rang, and it said, "You are what you eat." And I'm really looking for some help here. I can't, like I said, I can't go to the police. I need some help. And if any kind of I don't feel safe. I need to feel safe. And I'm a problem. If you guys could help me feel safe, like, you know,
put the pickles in the bologna.
Like, some part of my,
yeah, roll it up.
I don't feel full. Like, I don't have much to eat now. And I would just really appreciate if we can do this today, or it appears that I'm being catfished now. And I was making videos.
Hello? What was it?
My backyard's the best grocery store in the world. Better than Whole Foods, better than Trader Joe's, better than any one of those little boutique-y spots. Like, what? You import fish from Nova Scotia? You got cheese from the moon, too? Woo! We found a fish head!
All right. Oh, it looks like the runoff pickled its eyeballs or something. That's gonna be good.
You know, when people think about foraging, they usually think Scandinavia, you know, the Czech countryside, forests. Me? I've got everything I need right here in downtown LA. Some people call me a dumpster diver, and no disrespect to dumpster divers, but it's kind of like calling a kid in a sandbox a paleontologist. Unless you have a degree, you're probably not going to find any dinosaurs. I'm getting pneumonia. Could be cat piss.
Where'd you go to school, Shiza?
Me. I went to the school of the streets.
Yep. Last time I wore chef's whites was probably in here.
To be honest, I think I probably taught them about as much as they taught me. Probably more.
Chazelle. He was my best student, by far. By far. One day he comes in hungover, stinking of sex and dumpster mushrooms.
It's great.
Kids were supposed to present a bake they prepared overnight. I look at him, I go, Chazelle, where's your tart? He looks over the bakes the other kids prepared, grabs one from another student named Kimmy, puts it down in front of me. I go, Chazelle, that's Kimmy's duck tart. Where's your tart? He digs in his pocket, pulls out a Ziploc bag filled with a dandelion puree, spreads it over the tart. He goes, I found the dandelions outside. I found a duck tart inside. What's the difference? Well, the difference was the dandelion puree was sublime. Kimmy's duck tart tasted like shit.
Yeah, some places in LA, it feels like there's only a few options. Sports. Crime, culinary arts. I used to watch the older kids grilling on the corner. Sausages, simple remoulades. I thought to myself, that's what's gonna get me out of here. Turns out, that's what makes me want to stay. Can't spell voila without LA.
He's never left LA, I'm serious. He's never gone outside the city limits. He goes once a year to the Santa Monica Pier for barnacles, and that's it. Mm-hmm. With Chazelle Vine, you never know what you're going to eat, but you know it's local.
Yeah. San Bernardino. Hundreds of miles, probably. Hey there.
Hi.
Chazelle. Chazelle Vine, yeah. You probably know. Where's the farm?
San Luis Obispo, CNL Farm.
Oh, yeah. So, well, that's like few hundred miles.
Up north, like 3.5 hours away.
So you like grow the food up there.
And we bring it all the way over here.
You put it in a truck. You bring it down here.
Yeah.
But even though there's food here.
There's a joke at his events, never to clean up Chazelle's workstation. He is just as likely to use something from his cutting board as something growing underneath it.
Come on, don't be afraid. So, these Echo Park ducks, if you look at their feet, in between the webbing, come on, don't go away. There's a really specific kind of scum, a buildup, which we can use for different kinds of fermentations. Just pick them up, scrape it off, doesn't hurt them. Come back next week. They know me, we're cool. All right, can you cut the camera? Mm. Snap the necks.
You watch him source his ingredients, and you hope that it's edible.
Do you mind if I buried a carp in here last week.
The way he seasons, he can make a rat taste like aged prime rib.
Like a fish?
Well, about a week, maybe a week and a half, and they start to ferment for a little bit.
Inedibly delicious. That's not an oxymoron for Chazelle Vine.
Uh-huh. Yeah, for how many? Yeah, okay. It's a producer. Wanted me to do the food for another Airbnb warming in Silver Lake. She called me a forager. That's like simultaneously so pretentious and basic.
What do you like your job?
Call me what I am. I'm a searcher. It's like that old song by the CSI Miami guys. Call me the searcher. And I've been getting low and... Ah! Oh, fuck. It's not Cali weed. Man, that's not local. Oh. Watch it! You know what you just stepped on? You see, the messed up thing is, you know, I get all my food in this accessible, like, orthopedic way. And then all these rich people want to bring me on their private jets and give me another Michelin star, you
know. Here you are, my little enfant terrible malte delicious.
Mwah!
You look like Santa Claus with that sack.
Yep, no reindeer here. Say that for the Scandinavians.
No, we don't want no dandy scandies. We want real, gritty, raw. There's something moving in here.
Of course. We've got all of LA in that bag. And what will be more moving than the city I grew up in?
Do you hear the crickets?
Do you taste them?
Yeah.
People come up to me and say, sometimes I get sick after eating your food. Well, I say, you're homesick. Even if you're from Belarus, what I do is going to make you think of home because my dishes are so grounded. When you taste my clams, you taste Venice Beach. When you taste my greens, you taste Elysian Park. When you taste my shepherd's pie, you taste the roar of the fans at Dodger Stadium and the squeak of the rats that I found in its parking lots. If you're searching for a searcher, well, you found me.